Transduction in the bacteria. Transduction is very important genetic process in the genetics. However, in this bacteria, here it is concerned with the help of the bacteriophages. Transfer of the one gene to another gene through the help of the bacteriophages will be called here as transduction. And we will see its role in the evolution, whether the transformation, we have just seen the transformation's role and its medically uses, whether we can use it in the, for our medical purposes, for the gene therapy or for the drugs against the viruses or the bacteria to control the bacteria. We can use the bacteriophages to control the bacteria. We can use to make the changes in its genome by our own will. Similarly, we will see here the transduction. So here the process by which any bacterial DNA is transferred from one bacterium to another bacterium, but with the help of the bacteriophages, will be called as transduction. And what are the roles of the transduction here? What are the advantages or the disadvantages of the transduction? What are its medical roles, medical uses, or the medical applications? In the specialized transduction, just to understand what the transduction is, we can just have a look at this diagram. This is the virulent phage, donor cells, and the donor cells chromosome is here, the host, and then the phage is going to enter inside the DNA. Then the viral DNA integrates into the chromosome, just the normal way of the replication, because the viral gene use the host machinery, and then the cell lyses, and there will be a large number of the bacteriophages will be the produced here, the recipient cells. Now these produced bacteriophages will go to see another host cell for their replication again the recipient cells. The bacteriophages are going to enter inside, combine the viral and the cellular DNA, and then they will be combined with the chromosome, and again the process will be started again. This now the from the transduction point of view, from here if we specifically insert a specific gene of our own interest, whether it will be transferred from one bacterium to other. Here is the bacteria number 1, and this one is the bacteria number 2. If here this phage contains, or this bacteria contains some of the virus, some of the DNA of our own interest here, whether when the phage is going to interact, here the phage is going to replicate with the help of the host machinery. Whether the, just like we see in the last slides, the experiments of the Smith, in which he incorporated by its own genes, and then this gene will contain in the bacteriophages. Then these bacteriophages are going to infect another bacterium. Whether here in this bacterium, whether we can transfer the gene of our own interest in this bacterium or not. This is called transduction, and the Smith experiment is successfully, we have transferred the gene of our own interest. So this transduction is very rare. There are very less chances of such kind of the transduction occur in the naturally. However, very small percentages of bacteriophages carry the donor bacterium's DNA. It is possible, maybe in the small number, but however, some of the bacteriophages can carry the traces of the bacterial DNA. And then one phage, maybe the chances are 1 into 10,000 bacteriophages, it can still get some of the traces of the bacterial DNA, and then that bacterial DNA can be transferred into another bacterium. However, there is no physical contact between the donor and the recipient's bacterium, which makes it a little bit more difficult. And it was discovered in the Salmonella in 1952 that when the one bacterium to the other bacterium, transduction occurs and the genes can be transferred, of genes of our own interest can be transferred from one bacterium to another bacterium. So from the medical point of view, from the human beings point of view, this is very important. Whether the resistance to the antibiotic drugs is very important, because there are so many years we still don't have any other antibiotics, and all those antibiotics, maybe we have already studied that Europe is going to ban the antibiotics because of the antibiotic resistance. All of our organisms or our bodies are become the organisms because there are a big mutation rate. and because of some other reasons they have become resistant to those antibiotics which we are already using for the decades. So for so many decades we don't have some new antibiotic, we don't have some new drugs. For this purpose, this is very important that we can use the medically applied bacteriophages for our own purpose, for our own interests. And similarly, the gene therapy is also very important. We can use the genes for our therapeutic ways. We can just silence some of the genes, we can interfere with some of the genes, and we can see the results, we can make the results of our own interest, which will be very important from the transduction in the bacteria's point of view.